DJ Remise.
What up?
It's like, starting like
the morning off good.
5:30 in the morning. Hold on. Starting the morning off.
Why do you gotta show the kids that?
That's how we do road trips. Mexican style. Arizona, here we come.
Pretty combo.
Breakfast. Chevron. Can we get some free gas for this being on a video?
You know what time it is. Can't nobody do it better than me.
No.
We as hot as 1,000 degrees. When we on the block, we mash with cheese. You're in my face, then you're the reason. Can't nobody do it better than me.
No.
We as hot as 1,000 degrees. When we on the block, we mash with cheese. You're in my face, then you're the reason.
Big psych, thug life in the building. Still sucker ducking, trying to get another million. Cause there's so much trouble in the world. Gotta watch these haters, get your paper, baby girl. A Tupac disciple with a rifle.
Yeah, we're in fucking Phoenix, Scottsdale, some shit. This was bumping fucking TikTok.
I don't even know what I just said.
Yeah, we probably shouldn't have drank that Patron.
But it's okay. It's gonna be a long day. It'll keep us going or something.
I don't even know where we're at.
Break it off right here. Why not?
Did they use my turn signal?
Nah.
$285 miles from Vegas.
That's a lot of money.
Next stop, the studio.
Yeah, buddy.
Presented by Phoenix VIP Events and Crush Recording Studio. And hosted by Tupac Road Dogg, Big Psych himself. 101.5 Jams DJ Decipher on the decks all night long with special guest appearance by DJ Super James live from Las Vegas. Cream Stereo Lounge on 3rd and Drinkwater Boulevard. It's all going down this Friday night. Sponsored by Crush Recording Studio. A Phoenix VIP Events production.
Yeah. We're clearing them out. Check out our...
Right on. So it's hard to think of Big Psych and not talk real quick about the association with Tupac.
Exactly.
What was it like working with him?
What Tupac gave me personally was an opportunity, number one, and then a work ethic that you cannot, you know, you can't buy it, you know, and that's what I've been doing over these years that I haven't put out an album, is that work, no matter what you're doing. Keep creating songs. I'm probably sitting on a catalog of 300 songs that nobody's never heard. So it's not that I haven't been working. It's just I haven't decided to put the project out. And the project for me, it has to be done right. By me being an independent, I have to cross my T's, dot my I's before I can even think of releasing an album.
Yeah. There's a lot that has to be kind of going on, both professionally, business-wise, as well personally.
Yes, true.
One more question. I mean, part of that whole scene, there was an emphasis on, you know, the whole East Coast, West Coast kind of thing. Has that leveled out yet?
It was a hoax. There was never no beef between the West and the East. Tupac is from the East Coast. All the outlaws are from the East Coast. It was only two to three guys that was around Pac and Tupac's clique that was from the West Coast. So to me, it was just, you know, it was just Pac taking shots at who he wanted to take the shots at. And then the media, which caused the whole problem, just blew it way out of proportion. It's the same thing that's going on now. Now rappers think that you, in order to be in the game, you got to diss somebody.
Right.
To me, it's like, why would I put somebody else down to put myself up? So I never got involved with that diss rap or none of that, because that's not what I got into music for. I got into music to make good music, take care of my family, and do the positive things. So the rappers nowadays that come in and they on some gang thing or whatever they doing, it's going to backfire on them, and that's what they don't understand.